1-3-1-2-3!
Logo!
It's been a great decade for Hillsboro football. The Hawks had seven straight seasons of eight or more wins from 2011 through 2017, with two district titles along the way. After six seasons under the guidance of Lee Freeman, a new head coach now leads the program. However, it's someone who Hawks fans should be familiar with. Bill Saharsky will take over the reins after having been an assistant coach with the program for over a decade. He says he appreciates the chance to be the lead man.
That means an awful lot to me. It's something I've dreamed about. You know, been here a while, and just getting that opportunity. You know, from a coaching standpoint, you're working with kids regardless of whether you're calling the offense or being the head coach. So that doesn't change. But just having that opportunity to kind of put my stamp on things is definitely something that I'm happy to have that opportunity to do.
This won't be Saharsky's first stint as a head coach in Southeast Missouri football. He was the head coach at Herculaneum for three seasons from 2004 through 2006, leading the Black Cats to an 18-14 record and back-to-back district titles. However, as a graduate of Hillsboro, he says it means even more to take over the football program at his alma mater.
Definitely a special. You have those opportunities. It's hard to pass up. Sometimes you don't get those opportunities. People will go their whole career, coach 30 years, and never be able to even coach 1 year at the alma mater, whether it's an assistant or a head coach. So it's definitely special having that opportunity to come back here and be the head coach and coach these great group of young men.
After a great run, the Hawks are coming off back-to-back four-win seasons, although last year included a 3-1 conference record and a share of the MAFC Red Division championship. The running game will still be a staple of Hillsboro football, especially with the return of sophomore tailback Jackson Patterson, who burst onto the scene as a freshman with over 1,300 rushing yards and 15 touchdowns. The big story for the Hawks will be who leads the charge under center. Hillsboro has two talented options in junior signal caller Junior Arnold and sophomore Griffin Ray. Saharsky says both players have shown that they're capable of running the offense throughout camp.
I feel good either way right now if we had to play tomorrow, if either one was in there. But we're going to let those guys battle it out and battle it week to week and see if one of them will separate from the other. And for us, it's, you know, reading the option and then take care of the ball in the run game. And I think both of them have a chance to do that. And if one separates himself, then he'll be the starter. If not, it may be a situation where they both get reps, you know, early in the year to see. I would like one to separate himself from the other so that we can have that designated starter. I think that's important. But if that doesn't happen, well, you know, they may have to battle it out early in the year.
Arnold had the opportunity to take almost all the snaps as the quarterback at the JV level for Hillsboro last year. He says the quarterback competition in camp this year is pushing him to be ready for the jump to the varsity level.
Honestly, I like having the competition. It pushes me to want to do better, try to outplay him. He's a good quarterback. I mean, it's a fight for the spot. We're always complimenting each other. We're making sure we're doing stuff right. But it's pushing me to want to do more, do better.
Ray would be making quite the leap to take over as the Hawks quarterback after primarily playing with the freshman team last season. However, he agrees that the competition with Arnold has helped prepare both the quarterbacks and the rest of the team.
It's going good right now. I'm liking the competition. I think it's making the team better, the competition is as well. I think both of us are helping each other out, you know, letting us know when we make a mistake, help guiding us through a little bit, you know. I think we're pushing each other and making both of each other better.
One thing that is certain about this year's Hillsboro football team is that they're going to be more aggressive on the defensive side of the ball. Senior defensive back Tristan Jones says that has everybody excited.
So our guys are fired up for this new defense. They love this new defense. It's like we're coming for your quarterback unless you get that ball away real quick. So all of our guys are fired up for this new defense. They love it.
And for Hawks senior defensive standout Zach McNeese, he says they're going to be playing the hard-nosed brand of football that he loves.
Oh, I love it. It's ground and pound. It's fly around, hit somebody. That's exactly how I love to play the game. Just full contact, full speed. That's the best way to play it. That's how it was made to be played. So I love every bit of it.
The numbers have been great for the Hillsboro football program this year. They have around 90 kids participating at the high school level and close to 60 at the junior high level for a total of nearly 150 players across the program. Junior Cody Smith says with a lot of players participating in Hillsboro football, they now need to instill a hard-working philosophy throughout the program.
So we got brotherhood. We can't have football without brotherhood. You have to have love. You have to have aggressiveness. Practice every day. Football's an everyday thing, no off season.
As Zaharsky enters his first year as head coach of the Hillsboro football team, he says expectations remain high, just as they always are. He says the goals never change for the Hawks, and those lofty goals are meant to push the players throughout the program.
Every year, you know, we have high expectations here at Hillsboro. We've set a mark of a relentless attitude, relentless effort. You know, our goal is to make a playoff run and try to get to that state championship game. That won't change. I told the kids, you know, our expectation will always be the same. And it's our job as coaches to push you guys there and have those expectations. As they say in life, you know, if you can't fail if you don't have expectations. And people who just want to go get through things, well, they're never going to achieve the highest level of success that they can if they don't have those aspirations. So that's our goal we've set. We've talked to the kids for years about getting there and working hard to be there. So that's never changed, regardless of how the season is finished. But improving as a football team week to week and putting ourselves in the best position comes week 10 to make a run.
Hillsboro kicks off the 2020 football season on August 28th when they head out on the road to take on the Northwest Lions.
We are!